Hello everyone. Dear students, you know that representing data by picture graph is not only time consuming but at times difficult too. Let us see some other way of representing data visually. Observe this video.
Creating bar graphs. Suppose we decide to collect data about the number of students in this class who go to school by bike, bus, car, or on foot. It is useful to organize the data in a table first. In the first column, we indicate how students come to school. In the second column, we write the count, using numbers or tally marks. Students who take their bikes, raise your hands. So, 5 of you take their bikes to school. How many take the bus? 8. How many come by car? 3. And how many of you walk to school? 9 students. Excellent. One way to represent this count data is to draw a bar graph. But what is a bar graph? Let's use a grid and label our categories. And let's say that coloring one square would represent a count of 1. We put this information to the side of the graph. We have 5 students who take their bikes to school. So on top of the bike category, we color the first square, and another right above it, and another, and so on until we've colored 5 squares. Notice how all colored squares combined make a long bar. Moving on to the next category, there are 8 students who take the bus to school. So on top of the bus category, we color 8 squares. And there are 3 students who come by car. So on top of the car category, we color 3 squares. Finally, there are 9 who walk to school. So on top of the walk category, we color 9 squares. And our bar graph is finished. In this lesson, you learned how to draw a simple bar graph.
So, dear students, in this class, let us learn about bar graph and interpretations of bar graph. Subtopic. Bar graph can be defined as a chart or a graphical representation of data, quantities or numbers using bars or strips.
Bar graph can be defined as a chart or a graphical representation of data quantities or number using bars or
strips. Bar graph used to compare things between different groups or to track change over time. Bar graph used to compare things between different groups or to track change over time. And bar graphs are easy to understand, widely used. Bar graphs are easy to understand and it is widely used. Here bars of uniform width can be drawn horizontally or vertically with equal spacing between them, and the length of each bar represent the given number. Such method of representing data is called bar diagram or a bar graph. Types of bar graphs are
vertical, horizontal and line graphs. Vertical graphs represent in this way, horizontal graphs represent in this way, line graph represent in this way. Next, we move on to interpretation of a bar graph. Interpretation of a bar. Interpretation of a bar graph. Vertical graphs represent in this way, horizontal graphs represent in this way, line graph represent in this way. Next, we move on to interpretation of a bar graph. Interpretation of a bar. Interpretation of a bar graph.
Let us learn how to read and interpret a bar graph. The title of the bar graph tells us what it represents. The height of a bar in vertical bar graph or the length of a bar in horizontal bar graph tells us the value in numbers. Let us understand by taking an example. The bar graphs shown on screen represents the marks obtained out of 50 by Atul in different subjects in an examination. Here the marks are represented by vertical and horizontal bar graphs. Now look at the above vertical or horizontal bar graph and read it carefully. You will find that A. The above bar graph represents the marks obtained by Atul in English, Maths, Science, Hindi and Computer Science. B. Atul scores maximum marks in math. C. Atul scores least marks in Hindi. D.
Atul scores equal marks in English and Science. E. Atul scores 40 marks in Computer Science. F. Total marks scored by Atul in all subjects is 45 plus 50 plus 45 plus 35 plus 40 is equal to 215.
Graph. Observe the video.
Now, let us look at the example of vehicular traffic at a busy road crossing in Delhi, which was studied by the traffic police on a particular day. The number of vehicles passing through the crossing every hour from 6 a.m. to 12 noon is shown in the bar graph. 1 unit of length stands for 100 vehicles. Observe here.
Was it 200? Here they given the scale of the scale is 1 unit length equal to 100 vehicle, that is 1 unit length equal to 100 vehicles. Here they given, this is x axis, this is y axis. In the y axis, time interval. They given that the number of vehicles passing through the crossing every hour from 6 a.m. to 12 noon.
6 to 7, 7 to 8, 9 to 8 to 9, 9 to 10, 10 to 11, 11 to 12. 6 to 7 o'clock. Observe this bar graph. You know that this is horizontal bar graph. We can see that maximum traffic is shown by the longest bar, that is 1200 vehicles for the time interval 7 to 8 a.m. The second longer bar is for 8 to 9 a.m. Similarly, minimum traffic is shown by the smallest bar, that is 100 vehicles for time interval 6 to 7 a.m. This is the minimum traffic. This is the maximum traffic shown by the longest bar. Next, the bar just longer than the smallest bar is between 11 a.m. to 12 noon. Consider an example. Read the adjoining bar graph showing the number of students in a particular class of a school. Observe this bar graph. One unit length equal to 10 students. One unit length means here we choose one unit as 1 centimeter. Number of students here, years. Observe this graph. In the x-axis they given years, in the y-axis they given number of students. Here one unit length represent the 10 students. Read the adjoining bar graph showing the number of students in a particular class of school. And answer the following questions here. First one, what is the scale of this graph? What is the scale of this graph? Scale of this graph is, scale of this graph is 1 unit length. Here 1 unit represent 1 centimeter. Therefore scale of this graph is 1 unit length. Next, second B, how many new students are added to every year? How many new students are added to every year? Observe, in the 2000, number of students 30. In the 2001, number of students 40. In the 2002, number of students 50. In the 2003, number of students 60. How many members are added to for every year? Observe here, 40 minus 30, 10. 50 minus 40, 10. 60 minus 50, 10. So, 10 new students are added every year. 10 new students are added every year. Next, C question. Is the number of students in the year 2003 twice that in the year 2000? Yes, because in the 2000 there are number of students are
30. In the 2003, number of students are 60. So, number of students in the year 2003 twice that in the year 2000. Yes. Next. You know that bars of uniform width can be drawn horizontally or vertically. This is horizontal, this is vertically, with equal spacing between them. Observe here, equal spacing between them, and the length of each bar represents the given number. Here length represents the given number. Such method of representing data is called a bar diagram or a bar graph. This is bar graph. Observe, the bar graph given alongside shows the amount of wheat purchased by government during the year 1998 to 2002. Read the bar graph and write down your observation in which year was. In the first question, the wheat production maximum. Observe this bar graph. In the year 1998, wheat produced 15,000 tons. In 1998, wheat produced 25,000 tons. In the year 2000, wheat production is 20,000 tons. In the 2001 also, wheat produced 20,000 tons. In the year 2002, wheat production is 30,000 tons. So, the wheat production maximum in the year 2002. And second question, observe the wheat production minimum in the year 1998. The wheat production maximum in the year 2002, that is 30,000 tons. The wheat production minimum in the year 1998, that is 15,000 tons. Next, observe the second question here. Observe this bar graph, which is showing the scale of shirts in a ready-made shop from Monday to Saturday. They given one unit length represent 5 shirts, and in the x-axis they given a number of shirts sold. In the y-axis they given days. Observe this bar graph carefully. Now answer the following questions. What information does the above bar graph give? What information does the above bar graph give? The bar graph shows the sale of shirts in a ready-made shop from Monday to Saturday. Observe B question. What is the scale chosen on the horizontal line representing number of shirts? They given or they choose one unit length equal to 5 shirts. What is the scale chosen on the horizontal line representing number of shirts? One unit length equal to 5 shirts. Next, observe C question. On which day were the maximum number of shirts sold? How many shirts were sold on that day? Observe here. Yes, Saturday were the maximum number of shirts sold. Next, how many shirts were sold on that day? Day. Next, D question. On which day were the minimum number of shirts sold? On which day minimum number of shirts sold? Yes. It is Tuesday. Tuesday. Next, E question. How many shirts were sold on Thursday? Observe Thursday. Thirty-five shirts were sold on Thursday. Next, observe third question. Observe this bar graph. In the x-axis, the given subjects. In the y-axis, the given marks. Here, one unit length represents 10 marks. Observe this bar graph, which shows the marks obtained by Aziz in half yearly examination in different subjects. In the x-axis, they given different subjects. In the y-axis, obtained marks by Aziz. Here, one unit length represent 10 marks. Observe this bar graph carefully. Now observe, answer the given questions. What information does the bar graph give? What information does the bar graph give? The bar graph gives the information marks obtained by Aziz in half yearly examination in different subjects. Next, B. Name the subject in which Aziz scored maximum marks. Observe Hindi, he obtained 80 marks. In the English, he obtained 60 marks. In mathematics, he obtained 70 marks. In science, he obtained 50 marks. In social studies, he obtained 40 marks. So, Aziz scored maximum marks in Hindi subject. Next, C. Name the subject in which he has scored minimum marks. Which subject? That is social studies. Next, D. State the name of the subject and marks obtained by in each of them. First, Hindi. In the Hindi subject, he obtained 80 marks. In English, he obtained 60. In mathematics, he obtained 70 marks. In science, he obtained 50. In social studies, he obtained 40 marks. We move on to drawing a bar graph. Drawing a bar graph. Consider example. Following table shows the monthly expenditure of Imran's family on various items. Items expenditure in rupees. House rent 2,800 rupees. Food 1,400 rupees. Education 800 rupees. Electricity 400 rupees. Transport
600 rupees. Next, to draw bar graph by using the following data. The given items and expenditure in rupees. To represent the data in the form of bar graph, here are the steps. First step, draw two perpendicular lines, one vertical and one horizontal. One vertical and one horizontal line. Next, along the horizontal line, mark the items. This is horizontal line. Mark the items here. First item is house rent, food, education, electricity, transport. Next, along the vertical line, mark the corresponding expenditure. Expenditure in rupees. Next, take bars of same width, keeping uniform gap between them. And very important point is, step 4, choose suitable scale along the vertical line. Let one unit length equal to rupees 200 and then mark the corresponding values. One unit length equal to rupees 200. 200, 400, 600, 800, 1000, 1200, 1400, 1600, 1800, 2000, 2200, 2400, 2600, 2800. Next, house rent is 2800 divided by 200, you get 14 units. Next, food expenditure 1400 divided by one unit length rupees 200, you get 7 units. Next, education 800 divided by 200, you get 4 units. Next, electricity 400 divided by 200, you get 2 units. Next, transport 600 divided by 200, you get 3 units. Now draw bar graph. House rent 14 units. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 units. Next, food 7 units. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Next, education 4 units. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Next, electricity, 2 units. 1, 2. Next, transport, 3 units. 600 rupees. In this way, we draw a bar graph. Dear students, in this class, we learnt about bar graph and interpretation of bar graph and drawing a bar graph.